to life when I met you. Reaching beyond the skies, running deep, stretching wide. Perfect love realized here with you.
Come on now.
Now the stuff is for real, you will never let go. Never let go. Oh, it's more than just words, love beyond my control. Out of control.
Heads up!
This is real love. This is real love.
Hey guys, how are you doing? I hope you're doing well. Hi. Kim says hi.
Hey.
Who are you saying hey to?
Hi, Kim.
She's saying hey to Kim. Well, here's the deal. I think it must be the rain, but we're having pauses every once in a while with the internet. So if it pauses, hang tight. It'll pick back up and it will go. But it is good to be with you tonight. I've got some news for you guys a little bit later, but let's start it off with this news. Are you ready for the news? Monday, 2 days ago, Kim, was exactly 2 years ago that we left out of Jacksonville, Alabama, moving to Cairo, pulled out of our driveway at our house there for the very last time.
Whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop.
And today, exactly 2 years ago to the date, not day, but date, was our very first Sunday at Eastside Baptist Church.
Whoop, whoop.
Yes. We are blessed, most definitely, to be here. I was telling Kim, let's just recap these past 2 years. Are you ready? Actually, it was Andrew and I did a recap. Are you ready for the recap? Here's the recap, okay? Right after I got here, we went through a very sad moment in time in the life of the church where we had like 12 funerals within my first 2 months here. Oh, that was tough. But in these 2 years, not only did we start that way, we've had a hurricane.
Mm-hmm.
We've had a tornado.
Mm-hmm.
We've had quarantine.
Yes.
I hate to see what the next few years are going to bring.
It's going to be good.
I know it's going to
be
good. But oh my goodness, so much going on. So, but anyway, we're going to get started tonight. And Kim's going to help me through all of this. But just for the sake of it, I was going through some videos. And I saw this little bitty short video clip. I think it was off of TikTok or something. But these two guys doing a little of their video to a Kirk Franklin song. And I thought the great thing about this little clip is going to be our theme moving forward.
Okay.
Okay, are you ready?
Sure.
Let's see what we have right here. Here we go.
Book of Revelation, chapter 7, verses 16 and 17. Yes, sir. They shall hunger no more, neither shall they thirst anymore. Preach, preacher. For God shall wipe away. Yes, sir. Every tear from their eyes. Yes, sir. Get ready for the revolution.
Come on.
What you say?
Come on.
Can you do that? Are you ready for a revolution? Hey, those guys are having fun putting it together. I think we can have some fun putting it together as well. Oh, my goodness. I know that we can actually start something new. That's one thing about this time that we've had for the past month. We can do a do-over. We can start over. We can make changes. We can make things better. But we can start something new, something for God.
That's right.
Incredible. So I just saw that video and I thought, oh, cool. We got to show that. Now, we got a little game. You know how I like to use emojis sometime in games.
Yes, and I'm not very good at
that. Kim's not very good on it.
He practiced on me last night. I think I got two of them.
Well, this means that Kim can actually do this game because she's already seen the answers.
I know the answers.
So... Here's what we're going to do. This game is an emoji. I'm going to give you emojis, and you have got to tell me the song by title that these emojis mean.
Okay.
Okay? It's going to be fun. It really, really is. I think I kind of skipped down, but here we go. Here's what it's going to look like. All right, maybe you can hear me. Emoji song titles. You message me on this. The first person to get two correct win, okay? The first two. So not, but send a comment. Respond on comment. Kim is going to be watching the comments, okay? Now, we're only going to give you about 30 seconds to respond, so it don't last forever and ever and ever, okay? So respond in this with the emoji, okay? Now, I'm going to be fair. It's not Christian songs. It's not bad songs. It's good songs.
That's why I couldn't get them.
That's why Kim couldn't get them. She's too goody two-shoes, only listens to, like, God music. But
I like my Jesus music.
She likes her there she goes, pulling out a Jesus card on us. But anyway, have some fun with this. Are you ready? Here we go. Number one. All right, I'm going to give you about 30 seconds. And the first person to respond on Kim's, you tell me what it is. All right. This is maybe a little golden oldie. It's from back in my time in high school, actually. The guy that sung the song actually went to the same high school. Yeah. Who we got?
Katie
is correct. It is Eye of the Tiger by Survivor. Correct. Katie was first on that. Now, the lead singer for Survivor actually went to high school where Kim went. He was gone by the time I got there. But anyway, I got some on text. Hey, guys, send it to me. Grace and Lily, you were correct. Send it to me as a comment if you don't mind. Kim's going to be watching it on her phone. But I appreciate it. You were correct. Okay. Eye of the Tiger. All right. You ready for number two? You ready, Kim?
Yes.
All right. Here we go. Number two. Oh, I know that one.
After you told me.
Oh, but I knew that one. I may have put this together so I know them. It may actually be in some of the games we're doing on the Disney Movie Challenge. It could be.
Skippy.
Skippy. All right.
Katie
is first again.
Katie's on ball tonight.
Katie, do you want to build a snowman? Katie, you won. But let's do a few more for fun. See how you guys do on this, okay? Number three. This is a fun one.
I think I got this one.
Kim actually is one of the ones that Kim got. It's true. And don't ask me how Kim got this one.
I know, really.
Oh, my goodness. All right. What do you think, Kim? You think any of them's going to get it? Oh, and Andrew got it. Oh, my goodness. Andrew got
Andrew,
it.
Andrew, Katie,
it
Tanisha.
Is
Woo.
Ice, baby.
Mary.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Andrew, you got that one first. What do you listen to, Andrew? All right, next one. What do you think it is? Uh-huh. What do you think this one is? All right, Kim. Kim had no idea about this one. So, here we go. A telephone with a face. Face with a... Hello?
I guess that's not it, Mary.
Kim tried
to
call
Dinesha.
Me. That is right. Dinesha got it. Call me, maybe. Yes. But, hey, Mary, Kim guessed the same exact thing. She did. All right, here we go. Just for fun, number four. What is this one? Do you have any idea, Kim? Yeah, I don't think you got this one, Kim.
No.
Kim had no clue.
I had no
clue
what this one was.
So
it hadn't come there.
Here we go. It is baby, old face. What could that even mean? Kurt Dog, you out there, do you know that one? baby, oh. Here we go. And the correct answer is baby. And
Nae
got it first. But it is, if you are correct, Grace, that is who sings it. But I think his music has changed since those days. I think Kim, he's doing the Jesus card music now.
I don't know. I don't be knowing nothing about no Justin Bieber.
She don't know anything. Well, you know he's at Hillsong and stuff, right?
No, I didn't.
He don't sing with them, but that's where he goes to church. True story. Last one, just for fun. What do you know? What do you know about this one? This threw Kim for a massive loop.
Yeah.
Big loop.
It's not a Jesus song.
It's definitely not a Jesus song. Okay. What do we have? Hey, Randy, what's up? Randy, glad you joined us. They're trying to guess what song this is. Anybody? Scratch your head. You got this.
Hey, I'm not the only one.
Everybody's stumped on this one. If you don't know, send a question mark. That way I know if you that you've actually seen it. Write my stars. Bright stars. Write my stars. It is... Okay, here we go. 30 seconds. Here we go. Are you ready? It is Blank Space, Taylor Swift.
Yes. Yeah, after he tells you, you're like, oh, yeah.
Oh, after
I
tell you, you go, I know what that is. Okay.
It's Tay-Tay.
All right. Hey, here's the thing. I'm in a very generous mood. Kim, I think everybody deserves a trophy. Katie, you're special. You won it. You got two correct first. I think Katie quit playing after she won.
No, she did.
Oh, did she keep sending something? I just didn't see it. Okay.
See, she said counting stars.
But anyway, Katie, that is actually one of my favorite songs of all time that's not Christian, Katie. I love that song, Counting Stars. But anyway, I think everyone deserves a trophy for this.
Okay.
So, tomorrow, after lunch.
I see where you're going with this.
Yeah, yeah. After lunch.
Yeah.
Kim and I are coming to see everybody.
Well, not right after lunch. I'll still be at work.
What time do you get off work?
Three.
So, after three, Kim and I are coming to everybody's house, making a delivery of homemade
cookies.
We got to do cookies because y'all know what Kim's name is with her grandkids.
Cookie.
So we're going to do some homemade cookies for everybody. Not just everybody that's online tonight, but every one of our students.
Oh, wait, look, Mary doesn't want any.
Mary don't want any? Oh, Mary, we love you anyway. But
never mind.
Uh-huh. Okay, plan it. Well, all right. Is pictures involved? Dinesha, you might have to fix your hair up this time. I mean, I don't know, but we got to do pictures. Because, you know, in a way, quarantine is kind of almost over. It's ending. We may have to do a selfie picture with y'all. I don't know. It's risky getting that close.
Is your arm 6 feet long? I don't think so.
Then I'll let you hold it.
Oh, yeah.
See, like yours not 6 feet
long. A foot long.
Hey, all right. But we've been in quarantine. And a friend of ours that we all know and love started a quarantine episode, and I've got his episode one. So you got to pay attention, you got to listen, because, hey, when it's Cool Carl, it is hilarious. We know that. So, hey, Cool Carl in real life quarantine episode one.
This week on Real Life Quarantine.
So life in quarantine, it's been pretty chill. I mean, we're hanging out, we're playing games, reading, and just bonding all around.
What?
So we don't have a lot of rules in this house, but the one rule I do have, no one touches my chicken nuggets. And today, someone broke that rule. Family meeting, now!
Now, I don't know a lot, but what I do know is when Carl calls a family meeting, someone's usually in trouble.
Here we go. All right, y'all. I don't demand much. I let you stay here. I let you play my games. I even let you use my hallway as a slip and slide. It was dope.
It was pretty dope.
But someone just crossed the line.
Wow. I guess you could say things are heating up in the kitchen.
Someone just ate my chicken nuggets. Hmm?
So what?
Shots fired.
So what? That's my one rule, Brock.
Well, it's a stupid rule.
Stupid?
Are you kidding me?
Also, there's more food in the fridge, man. The only thing in there besides my chicken nuggets is vegetables.
Carl hates vegetables.
I hate vegetables, and Brock knows that.
Good, you could stand to eat a few more veggies.
What did you say?
All I'm saying is that maybe you should take a break from eating 100 chicken nuggets a day and maybe eat a vegetable.
Whew. I'm pretty fuming right now, but I know I gotta be slow to anger and take the higher road. Be the better person. I'm not a rabbit, bro!
No.
I don't eat vegetables! I don't
what
eat Chick-fil-A chicken nuggets!
Dude?
That's it!
What?
Okay, first of all, bruh, don't cornstalk me. Dose of all, if you're hungry, go buy some more chicken nuggets. I would love to, Brock, but it's Sunday and they're closed. I bought these extra to eat today.
Then go to Mickey D's. It's all the same, dude.
What did you say?
I said go to Mickey D's. It's basically the same as Chick-fil-A, if not better.
The fact that Brock just said that, it scares me.
I'll kill you! I'll kill you, Brian! You know I love Chick-fil-A chicken
nuggets!
Yo,
bro!
Stop it! What's up with all this quarantine Carl?
Next week on Real Life Quarantine.
So I decided to kick Austin?
Oh, let's be honest. Cool Carl don't ever let us down. Hey, I wonder what episode 2 is going to be like next week.
I don't know.
So, yes. So next week, episode 2. Well, hey, just a transition from the game and Cool Carl and some things like that. Let's spend a minute here and just pray. Y'all, if you guys have any prayer requests, send them in and Kim will share them with us. But we want to pray at this time. Let's be praying about all that's going to be happening in the next couple of weeks. I've got some news to share with you about some things that are coming up. But pray for the staff and the leadership of the church as we've made some plans and we're going to start making some changes that are coming up that involves every single one of you. So just be praying, and I'm going to be honest with you. I was excited when I went into the meeting last night because the process of getting back together, that was the beginning process of it. But then through some very wise counsel of the leadership of the church, we made a lot of changes to what was presented, and I came out of there really excited about it. So we're going to be doing that. So prayer time, yeah, remember Stuart Hall. I haven't got an update on him, but we will definitely want to pray for him and what's going on with the virus and everything and people. If there's a good side to any of this, everything is pointing to we're on the downside of everything going down with people getting it and also. We do want to keep praying that we do things as we start making changes that we are still safe with all of it. Okay? But Andrew, I'm not sure. I haven't got an update in a while from him on Stuart. Okay, any other prayer requests? You have any, Kim? Be praying for our nurses and all those working in the medical field, definitely. Uncle Gene, Mary's great aunt, passed away on Monday. So be praying for her husband, Mary's Uncle Gene. So they live in Calvary, I think. Am I correct? So. I think that's it. So we'll be praying for your Uncle Gene. Be praying for Sam. She got a new car. Let's just hope she learns how to lock the doors so that things don't disappear. Yeah.
That would be good.
By the way, Sam, I threw you under the bus. Yeah, I meant to. Any other prayer requests out there? You guys, as you're finishing your home work stuff for schools and all that stuff, so we'll pray for that.
Seems like there's something, but... The Hensleys, remember them still?
Yeah, remember our friends of ours in East Tennessee, the Hensleys, that their son, 27, 28 years old, mm-hmm. passed away. Remember the Hensley family. James' birthday is Thursday. Absolutely. We'll remember that, James' birthday. I tell you what, it's no fun having birthdays in the middle of this. Is it, Katie? Makes it tough, but we tried our best to put a smile on Katie's face in the middle of birthdays in the middle of this. So
Katie
Reagan
says Reagan Cook.
Reagan Cook's family. Okay, Kim's putting that down. Okay. All right. Let's pray. I'm going to let Kim pray for us. After we pray, we're going to do a song. And I want you to enter into a time of worship with the song. It's a song that we've done many a time. And again, let me just reiterate, Grace knows this, Mary knows this. It is very, very, very hard to do this by yourself and record it and be there all by yourself. So just remember, Denisha's gonna be doing a song for us after we pray. And just pray for her because it's hard. This is really, really hard, all right? So, Kim, you have another prayer request? Mm-mm. Okay, Jamal says he's praying for everybody. That's awesome. Thanks, Jamal. Appreciate it. Hey, I'm gonna come see you tomorrow, Jamal. All right, let's pray. Here we go. Kim, would you pray?
Sure. Dear Heavenly Father, God, we come to you at this time, Lord. God, and we thank you for this time that we can gather, even though it's online, Lord. We We are here to worship you and learn more about your word. God, I pray for all the prayer requests, Lord. You know each and every one. Lord, I just pray for our church, God, as we try to move forward. Lord, and for the staff and the leadership, Lord, as they make these decisions for us, Lord, I just pray that you give them wisdom and guidance. Lord, I pray for Stuart Hall, Lord, that you would just please heal his body, God. Lord, I pray for the other people who have COVID-19, God, that you would just please, God, just please heal them, Lord. And I pray for the nurses and doctors, Lord, and all the first responders who are working with these patients, Lord. And I pray for our grocery workers, Lord, the restaurant workers that are able to go back to work, Jesus, and our truck drivers. Lord, I just pray that you please bless them, Lord. And I pray for Mary's family, Lord, and the loss of her aunt. I pray a special prayer for her uncle, Lord, that you would just please be with him, Lord, and comfort him. Lord, I pray for the Hensleys, Lord, that you would be with them, Jesus, as they adjust to a new normal without Seth, Lord. I just pray, God, that you give them comfort and let them feel your loving arms around them, Lord. God, and I pray for James's birthday, Lord. James is special to our church, Lord, and I just pray that he has a great birthday. Lord, and I pray for Reagan Cook's family, Lord. I'm not sure the specific need there, Lord, but you know, and I just pray, God, that you bless us only you can. Lord, and I pray for this time, Lord, that you be with us, Lord, as we go into worship, Lord, that you would just speak to us, Lord. And I pray for Robbie as he brings us your word. We thank you for your many blessings. In your name we pray. Amen.
The same God that never fails.
I can listen to yourself.
Will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Oh yes, I will lift you high. Fails, will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things.
Yeah, Kim told me to unmute myself, and I missed that somehow, some way. But let me just go back and repeat what I said again.
We do a lot of repeating.
I do a lot of repeating. Thank you, Dinesha. I know it's hard. The scripture verse passage where it says the strand of three is stronger and better than one is so true, and I think it applies to our worship group. They're all gifted, and God has gifted them. But it's like when they're together, they're at a whole new God level. Mm-hmm. And I'm waiting for the day that we get back to that. Not that I don't like spending time with each one to sing, but right. When it's just, there's something about being all together. Well, we're going to look at real quick. Give me just a few minutes, and we're going to wrap. We'll wrap up. It's not going to go. I'm not going to go that long tonight.
You sure?
I'm sure. Okay. I'm sure.
Can I do this if you do?
Yeah, okay. You're going to do that anyway, but that's okay.
No, I usually do this.
We're going to look at John chapter 16, verses, the last few verses of chapter 16, verses 29 to 33. But I think this probably is a great application for us because every one of us are sick and tired with what's been going on, if you can get burned out of being quarantined, we're burned out.
We've been able to go to work.
And we've been able to go to work, yeah. I want to read this and just kind of see what Jesus was talking about. But before we dive in, I want you to understand that Jesus had just been spending, this is just before he was arrested, okay? He has spent 3 years with his disciples, and he's talking to the disciples right here. And let's be honest, for the disciples, they've had it pretty easy because Jesus has done everything. He's done the speaking, he's done the preaching, he's done the healing. He's done everything for them. Everybody was following them for Jesus, okay? The disciples just at this point have been spending 3 years of learning all things God, learning that what God wanted to use them to do, okay? And throw a little twist to it. I know that I kind of mess around and sometimes I pull stuff out of nowhere when I talk to you and you're like looking at me like, where'd you come in from with that? What do you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know I do that. And I do that intentionally. But Jesus had just spent 3 years speaking to the disciples in parables and metaphors. And they've been having to spend 3 years trying to figure out what he's meaning. When he says, you can tear this temple down, and in 3 days I build it back up, their mind's blown because it had taken them years and years and years to build a temple, and he's going, they're in their mind going, you're going to tear it back? You're going to build it back? So he'd been speaking in a lot of metaphors and parables and stuff, okay? And they've learned through it. They've learned great things of God through the way he was teaching and all. But that kind of leads us up to where we are right now in verse 29.
Okay,
here's what it says. His disciples said, and now you're speaking plainly and not using figurative speech. They're going, oh, so now you talk to us and telling us what you really mean. We don't have to figure it out. He's going, now you're telling us exactly what you want us to know. Okay? And they go, now we know that you know all things and do not need anyone to question you. In other words, they're saying, now we figured it out, but now you're telling us you know all things. No one has to ask you for anything because you already know all things. And when he says no one has to question you, that's what they mean is nobody has to ask Jesus for things because he already knows. And so it's like with the disciples, a light bulb just come on. It's just like they're going, oh, wow. This is the Son of God. He does know all things. Mm-hmm. I don't really have to ask. He knows what I need. But here's the cool part. Jesus likes to hear from us anyway.
Right.
He loves to hear from us, even though he does know. And Then they go on and they say this. This is why we believe that you are from God. Because they have figured it out. Not only is he been saying he was the Son of God, he has just revealed to them the proof that he was the Son of God, and they believed it wholeheartedly. They are now not willing to get out of the boat. They are ready to stay in the boat with him. Okay? They're ready for that. Now, Jesus says, do you now believe? Behold, the hour is coming. Indeed, it has come when you will be scattered, each to his own home, and will leave me alone. Jesus just said, now you understand that I know all things, that I know you intimately. He goes, but it's fixing to get bad. You're fixing to deal with travesty. You're fixing to deal with hard times. Your normal way of life is fixing to be turned upside down. You're fixing to be quarantined back at your house with no contact with anybody. And you're not even going to be able to reach out to me in the body. Now, understand, that's what he's going to. He's saying, it's about to get bad. Okay? Nothing normal about what they have been living is going to continue. They're fixing to, about to have their world just turned upside down. Okay? Which we know the end of the story, and we know it did, because he got arrested, he was crucified. They were running for their life. Okay, they were rejecting and denying him and everything else. They were about to have to live in a new normal. With all that was going to happen with Jesus' trial, his arrest, his trial, his death, his resurrection, his coming back to see them before he ascended, their life was going to be a total new normal. I think we can relate to that. Our world's been turned upside down. Some of us, through all of this, it's like, man, I need a break. I need to get out of my house. My brother, my sister is driving me nuts. My mom and dad are just, I gotta get a break. It's gonna get tough. It's been tough. But here's the best part of this message. Through all of this, Jesus says, take heart. Put a smile on your face. I am not going to leave you with nothing. I am going to walk you through the most difficult of times. Here's what he said, and I love this part of it. Understanding what led to it, he goes on, it has come when, he said, you're going to be scattered each to your own home and will leave me alone. He goes, yet I'm not alone. See, Jesus, just a truth that he just relayed. God is always with him. He said, even though you leave me, I'm not alone. Which is true for his children. Okay, he says, I am not alone, for the Father is with me. Through the middle of our world being turned upside down, nothing that we expected was going to, our birthdays are all jacked up and messed up. Our graduations are just messed up through and through. Some weddings are messed up. Funerals are messed up. Everything is messed up. But he's saying, in the middle of that, the Father is still with me. The Father is still with us. God is still there. Just think about this. None of this caught God by surprise. None of this caught. And this is the same God that created the world, that created us. It says he is still with us, even in the midst of it. But here's what. Knowing that God is with us, to walk with us. You know, he don't promise to take away all our hard times. That's nowhere to be found in the Bible. But he promises to walk with us through the most difficult times, to help us, to be our strength, to be our resource for help through the most difficult time. He promises to be there. He goes, then Jesus says this, I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. You understand that to have peace, and peace is tied to joy. To have peace in the middle of chaos, in the middle of turmoil, in order to have peace, it's only found in Jesus Christ. If we want true peace, we have to have accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, because true peace comes through him. He said, true peace and joy is found in him. Then he says, in this world, in other words, this stuff that goes on around us everywhere else, which we have no control over, in the world, you will have tribulation. You're going to have hard times. You're going to face difficult times. You never know, may face another virus. We may face some even more difficult times that may be worse. I have no idea. But he says, in this world, because we live in this world, we're not of this world, but we live in this world. As believers, we're God's family, but we're here. We're going to have hard times. We're going to have difficult times. But he says, take heart. Be of good cheer. Take heart means have confidence, knowing that he has overcome it. Jesus says, take heart, I have overcome the world. In other words, everything we face, he has already defeated on the cross. He's defeated it. He's defeated illness, he's defeated death, he has given us life. And Jesus says, in the middle of all this new norm that everybody wants to talk about, Jesus has overcome that we can have peace, we can have joy because of him. So I just wanted to share that with you. I thought it was incredible knowing, you know, that's something that only believers can have, peace and hope that comes through Christ by accepting him. And God says, I will always have it for you. And I thought that was pretty cool. So I hope that just maybe something quick, something short for you guys as an encouragement to you. And so thank you for joining on tonight. One thing is, we've got going on our Disney challenge. If you've not voted for today's, that's fine. You can look at this and see who's won and who's lost so far. It's going to be fun. Just remember, this won't end till next week. But who wins this is going to win a big prize. Whatever it is, it's going to be big. We're going to find something that's really cool, that's really big for you on that. Okay? Today's
a Polar Pop.
Polar Pop. Tomorrow we're voting on the live action. Okay? So it'll be a lot of fun. You can see what's going on there. And then we'll take a break Friday. Monday we're going to be on round two. Monday we'll vote round two of the classics and Pixar. Both will be Monday. Then Tuesday is round two of the other two sections. By the end of next week, we're done. We're going to be finishing. I may plan it for a special occasion, see who wins. But anyway, hey, are you ready for some good news? Anybody want to hear some good news?
Yes.
You want some good news?
Yes.
Hey, raise your hand. Let me see your hand if you want some good news.
Some good news.
Yeah, we want some good news. Here's some good news. Okay.
Y'all pay attention.
Pay close attention.
Close attention.
Here we go. You ready?
Open both ears.
May 13th. 2 weeks from tonight. May 13th. We have our first ESM worship back in person.
Woo woo! Woo woo!
Yes.
Yeah! Yes.
Now, here's how it's going to look.
It's going to look different.
It's going to be different. We're actually going to be meeting in the sanctuary for that night so that we can still abide by the social distancing request.
So we still can't get hugs.
Can't get hugs yet. Not yet.
Man.
But we're going to have our first ESM worship in the sanctuary May 13th at 6:15, we will start. At 5:45, we're having social distancing pizza outside the sanctuary.
What kind of pizza is that?
It's good pizza. We just have to eat it 6 feet away from everybody.
Oh, okay. I thought you came up with a new kind of pizza.
No, it's not a new kind of pizza. Okay? So, for our worship team, if your parents...
Are they going to sing 6 feet apart?
Well, we'll practice 6 feet apart and we'll sing 6 feet apart. But our worship team, if you can meet with me on Sunday evening, May 10th.
It's Mother's Day.
That's Mother's Day. Maybe Monday. You're out of school. Maybe Monday evening, May the 11th. We'll practice for a couple of songs for you guys to lead us on May the 11th. I'll send you a time, and I'll, Randy, yes, you can come, most definitely. Now, this is it's not for the children, but all upcoming sixth grade and up come that night. 5:45, we'll have pizza. 6:15, we're going to have a good time. It's going to be fun. We're going to try to make it a special, special occasion. Now, that's May 13th.
Hey, I just had a thought.
What was your thought?
Social distancing. When we do worship, that means we can all have our own little bubble.
Everybody can have their own worship bubble.
Sing
going
as
on.
Loud as you want to sing to Jesus.
Yes, even Curtis can sing out because nobody be in his 6 foot
right.
bubble
nobody
and nobody
be able to
hear
him.
Yeah, yeah. But hey, for that Sunday before, are you ready for this?
Mother's Day?
On Mother's Day.
No way.
Mother's Day, we're going to celebrate your moms. You ready? Mother's Day, we have our first Sunday school and church worship that morning.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Here's how it's going to work. Let me just tell you.
We get to see our peeps.
We're going to be able to see our peeps. Okay?
That's so exciting.
Here. Hey, Sunday, May 10th, Sunday school at 10 o'clock in the morning. There's going to be, we're still going to have an online Sunday school, but we're going to have two Sunday school classes. We're going to have a large group in the fellowship hall, and we're going to have a large group in the sanctuary where people can socially distance themselves from everybody, have Sunday school. And then we're going to have worship at 11 with the same group that's in the fellowship hall is going to watch live streaming on the big screen.
Okay?
Okay? And then we're going to have worship in the sanctuary for two different groups, and we need to do that so everybody can stay separated. Okay? So May 10th, here's how it's going to work. I'm going to tell you real quick. Okay, Sunday school and worship, both young adult, journey class, open door, and students are going to be in the fellowship hall. Okay? All the others will be in the sanctuary. Children will be with families. Everybody will be with families on that day, okay? If anyone that's not part of any of those particular groups can go to either one, okay? So that is what's going on. Now, only certain doors will be open. You can enter the fellowship hall from the double glass doors at from the south side of the campus, double glass doors into the welcome center and go to the fellowship hall, okay? Sanctuary will enter from the parking lot only glass door, okay? Limited restrooms, but we will have restrooms, and we're only doing the one-seater restroom so that there's not groups in restrooms, just kind of for now, okay? And just remember, no hugs yet, no handshakes yet, social distancing. Hey, but we're going to get started, okay?
How do we get to see each other?
Okay. All right. Randy, I don't... we're on pause here for some reason. Here we go. Is it back working? Randy, you can come and visit with us, worship with us at night. That's not a problem. All right, if you have any questions, shoot me a text. I'll be glad to answer. In the meantime, we love you guys. We're praying for you guys.
See y'all tomorrow.
And we will see you tomorrow with fresh, homemade
cookies.
I get to live with cookies, so I have cookies all the time. Yeah, I know that sounded weird, but it's true. Yeah. But anyway, we love you guys. We will see you tomorrow. God bless you. We are excited that the 13th cannot get here fast enough.